And for those of you watching, his name is Moses Barbosa.
Well, it's been a week now since this propane tanker caught fire in Lincoln, forcing thousands of people to flee their homes as that fire just raged there in that tanker.
Yeah, KCRA3's Tom Duhane is there right now tonight with new information on the search for what caused that fire. Tom?
And sources are telling KCRA 3 News tonight that the employee who was up on top of that tanker doing his job who was burned was actually a man who they say follows safety regulations to the letter. And so far the interviews with him have revealed no mistakes on his part. We also found some people today who live nearby and are not concerned about it happening again. The resident closest to the tanker fire is Deanna Beale, who has decided not to move. Have you made a decision, though, about whether you still feel safe or not?
I feel, yeah. Yeah, I just think it was a fluke.
Meanwhile, inspectors were back today. In the orange vest is a state railroad inspector. The man taking pictures is with Heritage Propane, the parent company of Northern Energy. The cause of this fire is still unclear.
The official cause is undetermined, unable to rule out mechanical or human failure, you know, human error. So we're looking at those two areas.
Meanwhile, samples were taken from the other rail tankers here. If the fuel is normal, they will be offloaded. Since the incident, the company responsible, Northern Energy, has been virtually silent. Nothing to say to the community. But now this sign has popped up. It thanks the first responders and gives a toll-free number for people to call if they suffered losses due to the evacuation. Heritage says all claims will be considered, but they decline to say which expenses are likely to be paid. Meanwhile, at Kim's Country Kitchen on Highway 65, the owner is giving a free meal to all police and firefighters who worked the emergency. That despite losing $10,000 while they were closed.
It's hats off to them, and they deserve it. They worked hard, and I would just like to let them know that I appreciate it, and I appreciate them.
And we've also been told that that tanker will be here for about another 2 weeks. It'll finally be removed by the tanker owner, which is a company called Union Tank Company. It'll be taken to a secure location and partly disabled. The top part and the valves will be sawed out and removed. And that's where investigators will continue to look for a possible mechanical failure for the cause for this accident. In Lincoln, Tom Duhane, KCRA 3 reports.